Hello everyone, I'm Sushmita Sarkar from RV College of Engineering, welcoming you all for Lecture 10 in Power System Analysis 2 course. Fine, so today in this particular lecture, we will see the problems on GS method, including only PQ buses. Fine, so I hope all of you remember the Lecture 8 where we have learned the Gauss-Seidel algorithm and we have seen how do we proceed till we reach to the line flows and line losses. Fine. So here we will be taking some two problems and we'll see how to get the bus voltages at all the PQ buses. So let us see the problem number one. Fine. So problem number one says obtain the load flow solution at the end of the first iteration of the power system whose line and bus data are given below. Consider bus one as a slack bus. So this is your, this table is your line data table. So where you can see the bus code is given there, by the seeing the bus code, you can make out there are three buses. So all the buses line impedances are given and this is your bus data. So bus data basically tells about you which type of bus is this. So bus number one is by seeing the data, you can make out voltage and angle is given. So definitely this is a slack bus. The next two buses, the load values data are given. So therefore this is a load bus. Fine, so the very first step we are going to do it, we are going to plot the network. We are going to draw the network for this particular line data. Then we are going to form the Y bus. Okay, so let us go and form the network. So this is the network we have, which as per the line data given, we have taken the inverse of the impedances and we got the respective line series impedances. Fine, so all of you can see the line series impedances over here. So by seeing this particular network, we are going to form an Y bus by using inspection method. Fine. So you can see Y11 is equal to 2 minus of 6i plus 1 minus of 3i, which gives you 3 minus of 9i. Fine. Similarly, the off-diagonal element, this which will be your Y12 will be inverse of this. Sorry, Y12 will be the negative of this. So it is minus 2 plus 6i and Y13 will be the negative of this minus 1 plus 3i. So you are getting like this. So obviously, I hope all of you remember the formation of Y bus by inspection method. So same way, we'll be forming an Y bus. Once we get the Y bus, we will use Gauss-Seidel voltage equation. So in this Gauss-Seidel voltage equation, before we start this, we have to take an assumption. What is that? That assume flat voltage profile for all the PQ buses. That is your initial assumption. So we will be taking V2 of 3 and V3 of 3 is equal to 1 plus of J0. Then we are going to substitute in this Gauss-Seidel equation. So in this Gauss-Seidel equations, when we are going for the first iteration of the second bus, so the formula says 1 by YPP. So P is your second bus, so Y22 and K is your 1. P is your 2 and K is your 1. Fine, so P2 minus of JQ2 divided by V20 of conjugate minus Y21 V1. Guys, I hope all of you remember that for the slack bus, we never write the iteration value because slack bus voltage doesn't change with the iteration. It is a fixed, which is specified in the question itself. Fine, that is Y23, V3 of 0, why V3 of 0? Because V3 of 1 is yet to be calculated. So we take the previous value, which is nothing but your initial value, 1 plus of J0. These Y values, Y21, Y23, Y22, we'll get from Y bus. Fine. What is V2 of 0 will be again your flat voltage profile from here. What is P2 and Q2? This is a very important thing. How do I write the value of P2 and Q2? So for that, you please remember. Fine. So P2 is Q2 is, we'll write the P2 will be is equal to the generation at that particular bus minus the load at this particular bus. Whether you write PG2 or you write P2G minus P2L, both means same. Fine. So I think for that particular bus, PG2 is 0. There is no generator data given because there is no generator connected over there. And this is given as 0.4. Okay, at the second bus, the value is 0.4. So what do you get answer as? Minus 0.4. So which you can see over here. P2 is equal to minus 0.4. Fine. Similarly, Q2 will be QG2 minus QL2. Okay, QG2 will become minus QL 2. Okay, so this value is going to be 0, 0. Fine. This is 0 minus of 0.1, which gives you answer as minus 0.1. So you can check this values as 0 over there. Just go back to the problem. Fine. So here you can see this value is 0 when nothing is mentioned, which means it's a 0 over here. And for QG2 also it is 0. So 0 minus 4 will give you minus 4, and 0 minus 0.1 will give you a minus 0.1. So very important to remember that your particular bus real power and reactive power will be the generation minus of the load. Okay, so let's go back. So we do like that. So let us see the values we put as per the equation. So what does it see? This is your minus 0.4, which we got it over here. And this will be, I just changed the color. So this is Q2J is minus 0.1. So minus 0.1, this minus will give you plus 0.1. So you can see in the next equation, I'll clear this one. Fine. So you can see in the next equation, minus 0.1, Q2 is minus 0.1. So minus and minus will become plus. So you get it as plus 0.1i. Fine. So all the other values you are substituting and you get the value of V2 of 1. So you can check out this value V2 of 1. It is near to your assumption value. What did you assume V2 of 0? 1 plus of J0. So your answer also should be near to your assumed value. This is very important. Please remember. Fine. Similarly, I'll be writing V3 of 1. In the V3 of equation, I should remember I need to put the updated value of V2 of 1. Fine. So V2 of 1 and V1 remains as it is. So put the updated value of V2 1. With this, we get an answer of 0.952, which is also equal to near your 1 plus of J0. Fine. So these two are giving me the bus voltages at the respective buses. Fine. So once you know these bus voltages, what is the next step we do in Gauss Seidel? We find out the change in the last two iteration values, which we call it as delta V. Okay. So delta V2 of 1 and delta V3 of 1 we calculate, and then we check the maximum delta V max, whether it is less than or equal to tolerance. Fine. So that is the procedure of Gauss Seidel. So let us go for one more problem. This problem is differ in the form of given input data. Okay. Not based on the solution. Solution remains same. The formula remains same. Only thing, how do you read the data? Fine. So the another problem you have where you have 4 buses and you have 5 lines. All these 5 line data will be given in your line data table. So what is my line data table? Line data table is this. So you can see it shows the sending bus and starting bus and the ending bus. Okay. And this is 1 to 2, 1 to 3, 2 to 3, 2 to 4, 3 to 4. The network is shown. Even the network is not shown. You should be able to draw the network by seeing this particular table. Fine. And then next we have the bus data. It's very important here. What is the important point to be noted is the bus data is in the form of injected power PI and QI. It is not segregated as a generation and load. It is given as a net power from that particular bus. Fine. So in this particular input data, in such cases of data, you should take the value as it is. There is no question of generator minus load, because by taking generator minus load, only the value is given. So in this case, it's very difficult to say which type of bus is this, whether it is a PV bus or PQ bus. So for this particular problem, we will consider this as a PQ bus. Let us say 2, 3, 4, all three are PQ buses. Fine. And we are going to take if the P2 minus of JQ2 in your respective equation. So remember, P2 will be 0.5 and Q2 will be minus 0.2. As it is, you are going to take it. Fine. So let us do the problem. So as all of you know, we have to first make the Y bus. So this is the Y bus data, which we have got after solving by inspection method. So all of you, please cross check this answer. Fine. Then flat voltage assumption, which is all the PQ buses will have 1 plus J0 or 1 at an angle of 0 degree. Fine. So now I'm going to write the Gauss Seidel equation. So first bus, definitely you don't know the voltages at the bus number 3 and bus number 4, updated values you don't have. So we are going to take the initial values and get the value of V2 of 1. So V2 of 1 is, I'm getting, it should be near to my assumption value. So this is your V2 of 1. Keep it in mind. Try to keep your answers in the form of rectangular. Fine. So I have given in both the forms so that you can cross check your answers. But your answer should, final answer should be a rectangular form, because we are more interested to know what is the magnitude of the voltage and an angle of the voltage. Fine, which we can get only in polar form. Similarly, V3 of 1. So here V2 of 1 is already updated. So V2 of 1 you are going to substitute over here. V4 is not yet updated for this particular iteration. So you are going to take the initial value of V4 of 0. Or in other words, you can take the previous value of that particular bus voltage. Fine. So here how much we are getting? V3 of 1. So V3 of 1 also we are getting 1.03. Okay, at an angle of minus 4.8. Similarly, V4 of 1. So here both the second bus and third bus, we have totally four buses, in which second bus and third bus voltages are already updated for this particular iteration. So we are putting that updated value, V2 of 1 and V3 of 1. So all of you would have noticed, I have not put any iteration value for the V1 because yes, bus 1 is a slack bus voltage, which doesn't change with the iteration count. Fine. So V4 of value, we are getting it as, after substituting all the values, we are getting V4 of 1 as 1.02 at an angle of minus 0.51 degree. Okay. So I hope here, remember that P4, Q4 will be as it is taken from the table. Okay. So I hope this particular problem with all the four buses where the bus one is given in the question itself. So this is a slack bus whose voltage and angles are already, magnitude of voltage and angle was already given, specified. Other three voltages we have found out. So all of you can check, it's near to our initial guess. Our initial assumption was 1+J0. So keep it in mind, your final answer should be near to your initial assumption. Fine. So with this, today's class, I stop over here. I hope all of you have understood the concept of Gauss and Gauss-Seidel method. And these two problems will help you to understand how to read the input data in different way. Fine. So thank you for listening. Have a nice day. Bye.